Hello, and welcome to the brand new Backun Alpha Low C Bass Clarinet. Many of you have seen the video that I put up on its big sister, the Model Q Bass Clarinet, and since the Alpha was released, which has only been about, 3 weeks, I have gotten no fewer than 300 emails and messages asking me to review this. Y'all are impatient. You're impatient. So when I was at TMEA last week, I managed to snag this instrument from the Backun booth, take it on the plane with me from San Antonio, only to get it lost somewhere in Atlanta, come back to JFK the next morning to pick it up and get it home, and now show it to you. Anyway, it was well worth the hassle because this bass clarinet is f***ing insane, and I will show you just how insane it is right now. Most people who wrote me called this bass clarinet the student model bass clarinet from Backun. I suppose that's true if you're a student, but in every way it is a professional bass clarinet that happens to be made of synthetic material. Maury doesn't like me calling it plastic because he thinks that sounds cheap. Well, I will still call it plastic because that's what it is, but you will soon hear that it is not the same plastic, that they make McDonald's spoons out of. It is a special kind of plastic that I'm sure Maury had some hand in inventing. It's also a professional quality bass clarinet that costs just under $3,500. That's for the low C model in nickel, which is what you're looking at here. For the low E flat model in nickel, the cost is about $2,600. So for that price, what are the compromises? Well, as far as I can see, there are none. The Alpha uses the same neck and bell. Like, you can take the neck off the Alpha and put it on the Q or vice versa. It uses the same key material. It shares the same key mechanisms. It's got the same bore and instrument design with the over and undercut tone holes. The only two differences, it's made of plastic and it uses Valentino synthetic pads instead of Pisoni leather pads on the Model Q, and it costs about 60% less. So before I say anything else, let me play it for you. Okay, now for the guided tour. First off, everything I'm telling you about the Alpha also applies to the Model Q. Let's start at the top. Here is the B-flat mechanism, the throat B-flat. It has a third pad, which is just for the B-flat. Why is this needed? Well, this will require a 2-minute bass clarinet acoustics lesson. On most professional bass clarinets, there is one register key, usually on the neck. There is a second key for the throat B-flat, but it's a compromise. It needs to also vent the lower clarion register, and it needs to play a decently in tune B-flat at the same time. It does a good job on the clarion, but the B-flat is almost always stuffy. So on the Model Q and the Alpha, and to be honest, on the $17,000 Buffet Tosca, which I have over here too, there is a third key intended just for the B-flat. It's a little bit lower than the vent, which is also there, which is why there is a third key. But this special B-flat key brings the B-flat in tune and it removes all of the stuffiness of that note. Here. That is the pinch B-flat, if you want to call it that. That's the side B-flat and the pinch B-flat. And the other cool thing is, this actually, underneath this pad here, that tube that goes in that makes the B-flat, you can actually screw it in or unscrew it to change the pitch of that B-flat, which is so flipping cool. I don't know if I have the guts to do it, but it is something that you can do. It's built into this, both this and on the Q. Next up, I'll show you the articulated G-sharp, C-sharp key. This is useful for moments where you need to go from, say, a lower note like the A to a C-sharp. Normally, you need to do this. You have to flap your fingers back and forth. But now with the articulated C-sharp key, you can just hold down the C-sharp, and the right-hand keys that I was just playing actually close that C-sharp key up here. Here, watch. Try doing that without an articulated G-sharp. So this feature is actually on many pro bass clarinets, including the Royal Firebird and the Selmer Privilege. But here's a cool wrinkle. If you don't want that articulated C-sharp and G-sharp key to work, and some people don't because it might interfere with how they finger altissimo notes on the instrument, you can defeat it by just unscrewing the mechanism. So see, no more articulated C-sharp. Let me turn the instrument around some more and show you this weird attachment here. It looks like it is for a neck strap, and you have three different holes that you could put your neck strap in. And it could be used this way, of course, but here's how it also can be used. I asked Jeremy Backun, who's Maury Backun's son, to make me an attachment to hold microphones, since I perform a lot with electronics. This piece here in the back can also be used to attach accessories to the bass clarinet, which is what I'll do right here. And then it holds the microphones in the correct position, which is great. Now for you, I don't know, you might be able to have an attachment that'll hold your iPhone so you can, I don't know, watch Netflix while you're practicing, or maybe a tuner or something like that. But for those of us who play a lot with microphones, this thing is so flipping ingenious. All right, let's talk about the right hand thumb fingering. It is, thank God, not D, D flat, C, but instead it is E flat, D flat, and C. Now, I know this might piss off most buffet, ubel, and royal players, but for Selmer players like me, it makes so much sense. I think it should make sense to everybody, but you know, why? There's a major piece in their repertoire that requires that this be an E flat. It's from the Schoenberg Chamber Symphony, and it is this bass clarinet lick where you play all by yourself, piano. And the reason that this is important is this needs to be an E flat. Otherwise, you're playing E flat, then A flat. You have to slide your finger up to this A flat and then play C sharp. Or you can play E flat and then A flat on the left side and then C sharp. Both ways you're sliding. Without this E flat key, I have in the past had to take my foot and hold down the E flat key with my toe and then play the low E fingering. So, and then go. That looks kind of weird on stage. So thank you for putting the E flat on the back, Maury. I so appreciate it. Besides that, all of the other low note fingerings with your left and right pinkies are the same as you would expect. It's the same on every bass clarinet, and it's the same on this one as well. And finally, let's talk about the peg. Yes, it comes with a standard length peg for sitting down, but it also comes with a standing peg. I think the only other bass clarinet that comes with a standing peg is the Royal Firebird, and the standing peg is used if you want to play standing up and not use a strap. The case for the Alpha comes in two flavors, the student model run it over with a school bus flavor, and a ballistic nylon backpack flavor. All the ones, incidentally, that I will be carrying in the ear spasm shop will come with the backpack, in case you're curious. So there you have it. I think I covered just about everything. Now, let's listen to it again and compare it to the Royal Max and the Kessler Custom Bass Clarinets, which are probably the instruments most people would be considering when looking at the Alpha. So here is the Kessler Custom. I reviewed this bass clarinet, I think about maybe four and a half years ago. This is the nickel version. And over here I have the Royal Max bass clarinet, which I reviewed in September 2022, I think. Here we have the Alpha, which I'm reviewing now. And I'm going to do a blind listening test with three bass clarinets back to back to back, and so you can see what you think and see if you can guess which is which. And I'm also going to throw in the Buffet Tosca, which is sitting over here, because as long as we're looking at some of the least expensive bass clarinets that you can buy, might as well throw in the most expensive bass clarinet that you can buy too. So here we go.
Mystery bass clarinet number one. Thank you.
what'd you think?
I'll tell you.
The first one was the Tosca. The second one was the Alpha. The third was the Max. And the fourth was the Kessler Custom. Well, what's my opinion? Well, I think the Kessler is still a good instrument for its price. You know, given that it's around $2,500, it's a decent instrument for the price. For $1,300, though, you get much more than $1,300 of added value, I think. So if you can swing the Alpha, you should get it. Dave Kessler is a good friend of mine, and they make a good bass clarinet for the money. But now, with this on the market, I think that the Alpha is more than $1,300 better than the Kessler. But now, what about the Royal Max? Until now, the Royal Max was the best value bass clarinet on the planet. Is it still something you should consider? Well, I know YouTube isn't about nuanced opinions, but unfortunately, this is going to be a nuanced answer. It depends. Some people like the slightly higher resistance of the Max, and for that matter, some people like the much higher resistance of the Kessler because it emulates the clarinet. The Alpha is much more free-blowing, which is what I personally prefer, and I think a lot of people should give it a try because I think you would prefer it as well, but you know you, and you know what you like. But I think you owe it to yourself to try both or even all three, and make that very personal decision on your own. Now, I know many of you are shouting at the screen saying, great, sure, I'll play both. Sure, I'll play all three of them. I'll just go down to the Starbucks and try theirs. I get it. Both the Max and the Alpha are gonna be very difficult to get your hands on, and even harder to find a place where you can try them both back to back. That said, I know a place.
This message sponsored by Ear Spasm.
I suppose the last question, the $3,500 question is, when will this instrument be available? Well, they're starting production next month, and I personally expect to have them in the Ear Spasm shop starting in around June, July, August, sometime in the summer of 2024. If you were interested in pre-ordering one, I would do it soon.
This message also sponsored by Ear Spasm. Now, would you please just stop?
In summary, for my money, the Alpha is the best synthetic bass clarinet that has ever been made. Ever. It is the most in tune. It is the most easy to play for me. It is the most adjustable. It is the best value. I would find it difficult to imagine someone could make a better bass clarinet. But that's the awesome thing about being a bass clarinet player right now. There is so much interest in the instrument and an equal amount of innovation being done. But today, February 2024, this is the state of the art. So, game on. Thanks for watching, and if you have any comments, leave them here on YouTube. If you have any questions about the bass or stuff like that, please visit me on earspasm.com and send me a message from there. But in the meantime, for those of you who sent me all of those messages and emails, I hope this is what you were looking for. Thanks for watching, and take care. See ya.